Hello everyone, Benvenue Europe, Mitchell Trench calling and welcome to today's D.E.R, where we're looking at 27th favourite. It's that one that just missed the cut into the final, in my opinion. These are all my opinions, remember. Remember, 39th favourite is my least favourite. First is the one that I want to win this year for 2013 Malmo Sweden for Eurovision. We're looking at 27th favourite being Belgium. Now, Belgium missed the cut last year, in my opinion, as well. I think they missed the cut in real life, too. But we're looking at the song called Love Kills, and it's sung by Roberto Bellarosa, and it is written by Jukka Immonen and Ian Farquharson. Sorry if I didn't say that right. I'm sure I didn't. But Ian Farquharson is, fun fact, he wrote Running Scared, which was the winning song for Azerbaijan in 2011, which is great. And the song is in English, right? Yeah, it's in English. Interesting fact also, Roberto Bellarosa is the winner of The Voice Belgium, which I always think is funny. I remember when Idol was a really popular thing around the world. It's not so much, it's very popular in America still, but that's really it. And parts of Asia as well. But when Idol was a really popular thing in Europe, you'd see Eurovision entry artists would be, they'd won The Voice in their country. They'd won Idol in their country. Now it's The Voice. They've all won The Voice. But anyway, let's have a look and a review at this song. Remember, original video is in the link below. Now, I've only heard the live version of this. It's the first time I'm hearing any studio version. And the studio version is a lot more synthesized. It's funny, they've done a great thing that I was going to suggest. They did! Because I've heard this is a real rock song. There was like drums, it was so synthesized, this version though. But I was going to say, it would have been so much better with just a piano and strings. And this version is piano and strings. The official entry version. They're going to bring in drums though. But I like that so much better. It brings up a level. Because the piano parts in this song is incredible. Especially in the chorus. I love the piano parts. I'm not going to say I would say he doesn't. But it sounds like, it only sounds like the singer doesn't really know English very well, because his pronunciation is just right. Well, if he performs it like that with the girls being still, I don't know how it's gonna go. But I like this. I love that piano bit there. And I love that love kiss over and over. I love that. And it goes into like this breakdancing bit. One last chance for love. I do like this song. I want it to be in the finals. But in the next couple of videos you'll see why it didn't make the finals. Because of some other people that had to make the finals. And if you're an ESC maniac, you'll get what that means. Oh! Little moment there. They have listened to me. When the version I've heard, they went into a key change. And the artist, his voice was on the edge of shrieking. And he was singing under the notes. And it was because it wasn't in his range. And this one doesn't have a key change in it. As much as I loved the key change, I actually would have suggested that they start in a key lower, like a tone, or a semitone lower, and had the key change, because I think the key change makes it. But if they would have had it on that same key and went up at the key change, I know in his live version, he wouldn't have been able to cut it, because he didn't really cut it in the version I heard. And I thought, oh, when I hear the studio, it's going to sound amazing, but they didn't add it in, so they're not going to add the key change in. To me, that's a big... it's funny. Oh, they listen to me. I like these people. Well, I have respect for Belgium already. They're reading my mind, which is kind of scary. I wonder if they're reading my mind all the time. I'm only joking and I'm being lame. But yeah, I think I said a lot in that video already. There's moments that I love. I do love that song. I've said all good things. I need to say something bad. Haven't I? What's something critical? Maybe the pronunciation of English, but it's not that bad. I mean, there's people that sing the English far worse. I don't know. I think really just didn't make the cut. And like I said, it's because some have to be in the final. You'll kind of get what that means if you watch the next couple of videos. Remember to subscribe to my account to see more videos come through. But if you're an ESC obsessed person like me, you'll probably get what I'm getting at. Anyway, so tomorrow we get to the finals. From now on, all the performances, all the songs and entries that I review are in my personal favourite of finals. I would have chosen them in the finals. So let's have a look at that tomorrow, or for the next review. So thank you very much for watching. That's really all I had to say for that one. But there are moments I like. I would have liked the key change, but I get why they didn't put that key change in, because that live performance was terrible with the key change. Well, it wasn't terrible, but it was kind of awkward sounding. Anyway, okay, thanks very much for watching. Bonsoir, bye!